But there again, I think that if you all think of it in a real common sense manner, you'll realize that nobody's going to come in here and give us anything. Just the same way, if you expect the government to come in here and give us anything, there again you're badly fooled, because the government don't give anything away. Don't kid yourself.
While everybody is talking about waiting for more tax area, and while they're waiting for the legislature to act, while we're waiting for this and that, our children are growing up, and there's no place to put them. We haven't a kindergarten in our school. I think we're the only school in the whole area there that doesn't have a kindergarten. Now, some people say a kindergarten isn't necessary, but I believe that all the schools around have found it to be a very valuable thing. And we would like to have a kindergarten too, I'm sure. But the reason we don't have is because there's no place to put them. Now, this spring, I believe we're going to have a short kindergarten class because we have a small group and they can be put in another class. But next year, we have a large group coming up. Where are we going to put those children? And to me, it seems that it's much more important. I agree entirely with Mrs. Swift that if we have to have a choice between a gymnasium and a classroom or several classrooms, we certainly ought to choose the classroom. And I would like to say also that the educational problems seem to be pushed in the background because athletics are popular. And probably it's a good thing they are popular. It hasn't been very long ago since our girls won the state tournament. And we are very proud that they were able to do so. And they won it, of course, from that gymnasium, which is inadequate. And everybody knows how inadequate. Well, that's where they have the training. Everybody seems to be aware of the fact that it's too small, that the baskets aren't placed properly, that there's not enough seating capacity. But why are we not just as much aware of the fact that our grade school is not adequate? Now, a lot of people say it isn't necessary to remodel. I'd like to see something done. It's about as obsolete as any school I have ever seen.
Thank you, Inspector. The board intends to build this gym out of an issue of $35,000, which can be done because they were down to see gyms that have been built just like the one that they're proposing here for that money. And then they expect to convert the gym so as to meet all the requirements of Mrs. Swift and these ladies have been speaking. So we agree. I agree with Mrs. Swift. We should have a better room for the grades. And we will have them. Now, yesterday we took a trip up to Blairsburg and to Randall and looked at two reconverted gyms. Those two gyms were reconverted just recently. I had a tape along to Mayo. And that is not a fisherman's tape, that's a carpenter's tape. And I measured those rooms, we measured them. And we found out that the gym at Blairsburg was 1 foot narrower and 6 foot shorter than our old gym. And they reconverted that. And on one place, we came in, they said, look out, the children are sleeping. They had their kindergarten in there, and the folks were sleeping on that floor. I asked the kindergarten teacher, how do you like this room? It's a splendid place, wonderful place. Now that's what we can have. And we can have all of this for $35,000 together with about $2,000 for each room that are reconverted. And the board can levy 1 1/4% or any mills on the total valuation for that purpose without a bond issue. So the board can go ahead and do this. Over here at Randall, they did that in 30 days, reconverted. Now, if we get this new gym built, then we can go ahead and reconvert the other gym and complete the job and have a place for our grade children. We have a place for the high school people. We have a place for the growth. And there is nothing that needs to be done over again. It'll all be complete when we get done.
Thank you.
So I'm in favor of this proposition, and I hope that it'll go through. I've always been a booster for Slater ever since I came there 40 years ago. I drove my car to get the electric lights in. We worked for the waterworks. We came on up and took one thing after the time. We pulled the old hitching post off the street. Now, there's nobody here want to go back to the hitching post today, but although they may be one or two here that would go back to the hitching post today. But I won't say for sure whether he'll not. But we're going forward. Then came the baseball park. I was for that. I gave my notes. You get Sir Kierge notes for that. I was for the putting in the anti-rust plant. Supposed to have better water. I've been for all of these things, and I'm for this thing that we are fighting for today, for the children that are here today and those that are to be born.
My point is this, Doc, and I believe you'll go along with me. We're on the air, WOI-TV, and maybe we might convert one or two legislature guys to our cause.
That's right. That's
and
right.
It'll help. That's why I like to drum up this tax angle, because it's the most unjust thing the state of Iowa has.
I have a farm, too, and I'll take that.
I know.
The moderator, they've got a better school than we have. What we're going to have to do is to get other people to come to Slater is to offer them something. You don't get people to go to the junk pile when you've got a good store across the street. That's the same deal here. We're going to have to get something built and get it going and get it, hope that they'll come there then.
Well, I don't see anything in all of this talk. It seems like we all agree we ought to have grade rooms and we ought to have a gymnasium. I believe in that. And when it comes to equalization of taxes, that's cunning. When it comes to increased territory and the greater the income, a larger tax base, that's cunning. Just as sure as the night's day. Night follows the day. That's something that's in there. And I have no misgivings. I'm hopeful that I've got faith in the future of our time and also of our town.
Doc, you know, with these high taxes on our fire, we might get back to 30s. You know, we might get the Republicans in. That'd be bad.
Town. People just don't have faith in the town. You're more pessimistic statements about what are we going to do. We're not big enough. We're growing. Have you ever seen any small town the size of Slater? Look at the young war veterans that came back after the war. Go out and check in your other small towns, see where they went. They went to the city where the high-paying jobs was. Just check your businessmen in town. Look at those young fellows. They come back and they live in your town. They got faith in it. You got a growing town. What other town of our size would build a baseball park down there? It didn't cost anybody a dime. We spent $16,000 in it, did all the labor ourselves, and we paid it off. So we got a growing town, it's got a heart, it's got a soul. It's a live thing. Every place you look, it's growing. Jesus, now here we stand around and we make all these pessimistic statements. Well, we can't be done, So let's get this plant going. Let's build a plant. Let's get this thing underway.
It's a growing town. They're working down John Deere, Woods Brothers, etc. and getting a free ride to school that I'm paying too much towards.
Okay. I don't say I get a free ride.
I'm $35,000. Well, I don't raise the free ride as much as this cigarette bill.
I don't like that free ride for John Deere workers. My neighbor bought a brand new house built right south of me up there on Bankrupt Hill, if you want to call it that. We got three new houses. We're going to have two more this spring. And he come from Des Moines. And for a better place for to raise his children and to work in John Deere. And we hope to get more like him. We've had a lot of good talk here tonight. This question of the new gymnasium and the grade school has brought the folks of Slater together, which is as it should be.
I don't know how you're going to vote. I don't know whether your decision will be for the gymnasium or against the gymnasium. But whatever that decision is, it will be a good decision. Because it will be your decision. Made after thought and free discussion. Your decision, which you can put up as a final proof to your community and to the other communities in the nation, that you here tonight have demonstrated the right of a free people to govern themselves. The meeting is adjourned.